this tutorial, we're going to use the professional edition of the PipeDraft plugin for SketchUp to connect hot and cold water piping to an energy-efficient tankless water heater. The piping configuration we'll create is based on the installation guidelines provided by the manufacturer. Be sure to check the requirements for your specific water heater and your local building codes and adjust your design accordingly. We'll be using SketchUp running on an Apple Mac computer. If you're running SketchUp on a Windows PC, the process is virtually identical. The hot water outlet line will consist of a relief valve, a service valve, and a drain line terminated near the floor with a boiler drain valve. The cold water inlet line will consist of a check valve, a service valve, and a supply shutoff valve. The primary hot and cold water headers have already been routed through this area, so we'll just need to connect up with the 3/4 inch NTS vertical lines along the wall. Let's adjust our viewpoint toward the bottom of the water heater and get started with the hot water line. Since we want all the hot water fittings to be members of a hot water line that's already in the model, let's open up the SketchUp Outliner tool and select the hot water pipe group. Let's launch the PipeDraft plugin and sign in to the cloud service. Click the Attribute Value Refresh button in the PipeDraft Palette Properties tool tray to display the attributes of the selected hot water line. This will also load the palette with the copper spec that's available in the PipeDraft Professional Edition subscription. The water ports on the heater are 3/4 inch NPS threaded male connections, so we'll connect to them using copper adapters with a 3/4 inch NPS female threaded connection on one end and a 3/4 NTS female solder joint connection on the other end. Now here's a common issue that you may experience. This heater was downloaded from a third party on the 3D warehouse, so the water ports are not piping components per se and were created using common SketchUp modeling techniques. If you try to connect to these ports using PipeDraft, they won't be recognized as piping connections. Fortunately, there's a PipeDraft component insertion alt option modifier key feature that tells PipeDraft to treat the center point normal side of any anonymous face as a virtual connection position. So, our goal is to position the seat of the adapter's female threaded connection precisely at the end of the threaded heater port. First, we'll choose the adapter from the palette parts tray. Then click the SketchUp graphic window title bar. If we don't activate the window first, SketchUp will ignore our modifier key. When using a Mac, press the Option key. On Windows, press Alt. Then we'll click a position on the face of the heater port. Next, we'll insert a nipple onto the end of the adapter fitting. By the way, in this copper specification, a nipple is simply a minimum length of pipe. They're handy in tight situations like this. Next, we'll insert a solder joint union and another nipple. Next, we'll insert a T that we'll use later for the safety relief valve line. Press the left or right arrow keys until the T is pointed towards the left. Next, we'll insert another nipple, adjust our viewpoint a little, then insert a ball valve and another nipple. Next, we'll insert another T. We want this T to be pointed at a 45 degree angle so we can route the hot water line around the relief line. Enter 45 in the SketchUp measurements box and press the left or right arrow keys until the T is pointing towards the correct direction. Next, we'll work on the drain line. We want the end located 6 inches above the floor, so we'll create a temporary guideline to use as a reference using the SketchUp tape measure tool by entering 6 into the SketchUp measurements box. Click the Route Pipe tool, click near the bottom of the tee, then click a position on the guideline. Next, we'll insert a solder joint elbow on the end of the drain line. Press the left or right arrow keys until the elbow is pointing away from the wall. Let's adjust our viewpoint nearer the elbow so we can clearly finish off the drain line. Next, we'll insert a nipple and an adapter since the valve we're going to use has a threaded male connection. Insert the boiler drain valve and press the left or right arrow keys to rotate it until the outlet is pointed towards the floor. Next, we'll work on the safety relief line. We'll need another nipple and adapter since the relief line also has a threaded male connection. Insert the relief valve and press the left or right arrow keys to rotate it until the outlet is pointed downward. The relief valve outlet has a threaded female connection, so we'll need to use a different type of adapter with a male threaded connection. Press the up or down arrow key to flip the adapter so the male connection is seated in the relief valve outlet. Next, we'll adjust our viewpoint a little so we can finish the relief line. Click the Route Pipe tool, click near the bottom of the adapter, then click a position on the guideline. We're finished using the guideline, so we can delete it. Next, we'll adjust our viewpoint a little so we can work on the last legs of our hot water piping. Insert a nipple and a 45 degree elbow on the open leg of the tee. Click the Route Pipe tool, click near the opened end of the elbow, then click near the end of the vertical hot water line along the wall. Next, we'll adjust the viewpoint a little so we can clearly see the final offset we need to route. Click the Route Pipe tool, click near the open end of the horizontal pipe, drag the mouse pointer a little towards the wall, then press and release the left arrow key to lock this route leg along the model's green axis. Click near the open end of the vertical pipe. Drag the mouse a little vertically towards the open end and click it again to close the route. Now we'll start working on the cold water supply line. Since we want all the cold water fittings to be members of the cold water line that's already in the model, let's select the cold water pipe group in the SketchUp Outliner tool. Next, we'll insert the initial fittings using the same procedures we used earlier. Next, we'll insert a check valve. We'll choose the valve with the solder joint ends. And press the up or down arrow key to flip it so the flow of the valve is in the correct direction. Next, we'll insert a nipple and a ball valve. Press the left or right arrow keys to rotate the valve into the preferred orientation, and press the up or down arrow key to flip it into the preferred direction. Next, we'll adjust our viewpoint a little so we can finish the cold water line route. Click the Route Pipe tool, click near the end of the valve, drag the mouse pointer down just a little, and click again. Click near the open end of the vertical cold water pipe, then drag the mouse pointer a little and click it again to close the route. Let's inspect our work. Notice that the final route is actually skewed a little along the horizontal plane to avoid clashing with the other pipes. Yet we didn't need to calculate the angle of the skew ourselves, we let the pipe draft router do the work for us. Now let's take a look at the SketchUp Outliner tool. All our fittings are neatly organized into the cold and hot water pipe groups. All we need to finish off our work is a cold water supply shutoff valve. That completes this tutorial. To recap, in just a few minutes we use PipeDraft to detail the hot and cold water copper piping for the installation of a tankless water heater. Please subscribe to the PipeDraft YouTube channel to be kept informed of newly released tutorials on how to use the PipeDraft plugin for SketchUp for creating spec-driven, three-dimensional pipelines for your industrial, residential, and commercial projects. Thanks for watching.